Hey guys, just had a big finding on the tips here that I've been talking about in the last video. Remember I took out the screw and I couldn't break it loose. And then I found what might be three spot welds under this thing. So I got my drill all set, all ready to drill. And I just gave this a yank. Boom! Boom! Yeah. Oh my god, this is what I needed. Oh hell yeah. Guys, I need you to find me some tips. The question will be, anybody wondering, it's a Forester tip. Good, no welding or nothing, cool. Oh, this inside is welded, that's what it is, spot welded right there. Oh my god, I gotta clean the... I'm going to get all this stuff off. It's going to be a big project. Clean off years of dirt off that thing. Get them sparkly. Get them black gloss painted. And I have to find a double tip. And of course, the key is getting the right, how far it's going to stick out. I can always, you know, trim this. I don't know, like down to here. Depending on how much I want it to stick out. It's going to be kind of hard to really estimate. I will probably have to put them on the car. Hell, this kind of looks cool. I wouldn't mind putting them on here just for another quote joke. Just put on raw pipes, that'd be kind of cool. Then I could do my measurements at the same time and determine what kind of tips. Now I want dual tips. I was gonna say black, but there really isn't a lot of point. I guess if it's a really good finished black, it might clean easier, and I could go with black. If not, I'll just go Magnaflow or something, which are a lot nicer quality than the stock tips, and easier to clean and everything. The Magnaflows are probably the best tips there are. So, whoa, let me try the other one real quick. I just know that one of them felt so stiff. I felt like it'd be impossible to get it off. I just kind of cranked on it. Yeah. Fuck yeah. Oh my god. It's going to come true. I am going to get the sound that I loved the one day I ran these things. And who, no clue what's different inside there. But something's different. Maybe it's just quieter. There's no real science to it. It's just a quieter muffler. Exactly what I want on that thing. In between stock and what I have now is what this will produce. I've been searching for this forever. Kept changing all those mid pipes. That's not changing the area that I wanted to change. This changes the area. I keep a nice throat with the mid pipe stock WRX. Just change the muffler to be a little bit quieter. And I'm talking because I have an aftermarket J pipe. That's why all this is necessary. If it was just stock, it'd just be stock. But the J-pipe makes it louder. Then the tips are good, but I want it honed down just a tiny bit. And then I have an almost stock sounding stage two, super stealthy, super silent. And it was just driving so good yesterday. Oh my God, that's awesome. I'm gonna start cleaning these up and I won't even make you watch that. It's gonna be a long project. I think guys, I'm gonna put this up in the Forester section so you're seeing a Forester title on this. These are Forester mufflers, Forester muffler disassembly. This one will go on the Forester playlist. I'll put, and because I thought of an insane idea, everybody with the Foresters can just swap out their tips super easily to some nice tips, not the crappy OEM ones. I'll put a link down to just some basic tips if you want to look at a few. But this could be, I just haven't heard of a lot of people changing the tips. Maybe they have, maybe I'm just not in the Forester world much. But it's so easy to change the tips. That would be the first thing I do when I buy a Forester. Either to a single or a dual, just a better looking tip. All right, guys. Just wanted to show you the first phase of cleaning. This was just with one of my nylon brushes and some degreaser. I gotta clean that brush off, actually. I decided not to use the brass. It's soft brass, but it's probably bad. It would probably scratch up all the finish. So they look cherry, but then I didn't get the hardest part yet. I made a dent in it. You know, this part I can probably, the metal polish will probably grab a lot of that. And of course here, that's just the hard, the one bad side right there. I got off more than half of it, but it's still, you know, a little bit bad. So I'm just gonna let these dry. And just wanted to show you the potential of getting them pretty clean is pretty good. So I'm gonna keep working on this project.